And you have to buy bread? And you have to buy bread? Oh, okay.
Mom, I hate bread.
Can't relate. Love bread. Send me to buy bread any day. Although I probably won't come back with the bread.
Mom, I need more money.
Ooh.
Oh, c'est l'argent pour le pain.
It's the money for the bread.
Mom and the movie?
Here.
I can take the car?
Dude, where's my car?
Can I take the car?
How old is this child?
No, I need my car.
Why?
To go to the... What a twist!
Thomas's mom has a car. Is savage. Love her.
Eddy, the doctor.
Eddy est au supermarché.
Eddy is at the supermarket.
Une femme parle à Eddy.
Bonjour.
Hello.
Ah, bonjour.
Eddy, whoa, flirt machine.
Moi, médecin.
Are you a doctor?
Oui, oui, je suis médecin.
Yes, I am a doctor.
Eddy n'est pas médecin.
Eddy is not a doctor.
J'ai trois voitures.
I have three cars? He's a liar. I'm going to put in liar. I live in a big house.
Mon pantalon coûte très cher.
My pants are very expensive. His expensive pair of pants. A bit of a step down from bragging about your expensive house than being like, and also my pants are super expensive. They cost like $80. Okay, but
un homme a besoin d'un médecin.
A man needs a doctor.
Il est très malade.
He's very sick. Eddy speaks with another woman. Are you a doctor? Oh, Eddy, not cool, man. Not cool. I am Suzanne. Oh, what? Who's Suzanne? Wait a minute. Lynn's at the train station. She sees her friend Martin. Oh, he's with a woman. So he's with Suzanne. So, and then Martin is connected to Suzanne, but we don't know why yet. It is Lynn. Me, I'm Lynn. Oh, I have to buy the tickets, Martin. Bye, Lynn. Suzanne goes to buy the tickets.
Suzanne est gentille.
Suzanne is nice. How do you know she's nice? It's been 2 minutes. And also she just said, hi, I'm Suzanne. Oh no, I have to buy tickets. Bye. And she is intelligent? Ooh, all right. Did they used to date? This is called the perfect girlfriend, so. Oh, he also thinks it's a weird question. Good. She's the perfect girlfriend. Girlfriend? No. Suzanne is my mom. Oh my gosh. Okay. Well, at least now we know how they're connected. Mom of Martin. Because she's just a very young looking mom. What does she look like again? Pretty good. It's hard to tell because they're cartoons. My train. Goodbye, Martin. Gotta duck out of that conversation really quickly. Fair. Little awkward.
I'm going out with a woman this evening. Eddy.
Eddy the player. I should add in that he's a player. Maybe he's not a player, but he does date a lot. This is the thing too, because if you look at the lessons, there is a photo of it's a drawing of Eddy and Junior, and then there is a woman who is also a ginger. So I don't know if she died in the Duolingo lore, but there definitely is like three of them in the pictures. So I am very curious if, or maybe it's just like an ex-wife, like he's a single father, but it hasn't been clarified yet because he does date a lot in the stories. The portrait. Oh yay, we get to learn more
Le
about
portrait.
Oscar. Did I add that Oscar is an artist?
Let me double check. Zoom.
Enhance. Oh, do I not have any notes about Oscar?
Is an,
no. So it's fine. We won't do any spaces. This is also art, you know? No, it's word art and it's intentional and it's not because even Wordmeister is like, are you sure? You sure you want to do this? Seems kind of weird. Seems like a weird choice, but okay.
You can't stop me.
Why is my head also big?
Je ne sais pas. C'est ta tête.
I don't know. It's your head. I love Oscar. This man is very sassy.
Le weekend.
I work at the garage. On the weekend? On weekends. Oh, that's right. Because wasn't she going to be a driver for a little bit? Lynn. Taxi driver. Briefly and then quit, right? Because then she just drove herself home. Works at the garage on the weekends. Kind of picks up a lot of odd jobs. Je suis mécanique. She's a mechanic. So she like works at the garage as a mechanic, but only on the weekends. And then also worked as a taxi driver? I guess this economy. Am I right? Oh, this economy.
To her apartment, right? Because she, her apartment, but the apartment is masculine.
Hey, Junior.
What?
Opens the door to her apartment.
Why is she there? Does she live with them?
That's confusing.
Potentially lives with Junior.
and Eddy.
I wonder if Lucy is like the grandmother, or maybe they're just friends and they live together. Lynn is with her grandmother, Lucy. They actually have... I mean, I guess this is gray and not a side shave.
Grandmother of Lynn.
Then Lynn would also live with Eddy and Junior if Lucy lives with them, which would be very weird, but maybe they just live in the same area, shared living space.
Aya is going to the house of her friend Deb. Do we know Deb?
Hey, Deb, how are you?
No.
First of all, you're a little bit intense. Second of all, good for you. I mean, bring up the fire. That's what I say.
A new one. And Deb, you are gonna be on your own, Deb. Deb, don't do this to me. Thank you.
Oh, why?
My new roommate is horrible.
Oh, I can see that. The kitchen is very dirty.
I know.
Yuck. These are some old bananas on the table.
There are some clothes dirty on the chairs.
It is your t-shirt.
These are your clothes.
And these are your bananas?
I don't like to clean, and my roommate doesn't like to clean for me. Oh, no. Friend of Bea. Very messy.
I don't know what you would call a person who expects someone else to clean for them. Presumptuous?
If anyone has a better word, let me know.
I feel like it is presumptuous to be like, well, I didn't clean, but my roommate should clean for me, so they're a terrible roommate.
Aya and her friend Ted are at the restaurant. Ted's new. I'm gonna have to put you way closer to Aya.
Come on. Come with me.
Come with me.
Okay, we'll do it this way.
We'll move you bit by bit. And you get a friendship connector.
Friends with Bea. This is the other thing, because I feel like sometimes Duolingo will be like, oh, these people are friends. And I'm like, are they dating?
Or are they friends? Are you trying to say they're dating, but in like a friend way? What is the nature of this relationship? You have not made it clear, Duolingo.
And I don't understand. Like, these people are out at a restaurant together alone. And I guess, like, you know, it's that whole like men and women can be friends. Obviously, men and women can be friends. I don't know. I never really go to a restaurant alone with one friend. It's always like a group of friends. But maybe that's just like, I very rarely go to restaurants in the first place. So maybe if I had more money, I would do it.
Do you want to drink something? We have a very special wine this week.
It's delicious with the plate of the day, but it's expensive.
It's not a problem. Two glasses, please. Ooh, Mr. Spender.
Mr. Nouveau Riche.
Ted Bonvert.
Pours? Would he pour it? Spills. Oh, he spills his glass in Bea's plate. Oh my goodness. Your dish. Your wine.
Bea eats. The server's right. The wine is delicious with this dish. Oh, that's cute.
What a nice way to make him feel better. I'm gonna also say that this guy is rich, because he said it wasn't a problem that the wine was expensive. Rich
buys fancy wine.
Get you a friend like Ted, am I right?
Get you a Ted in your life. Just gets you the wine and is like, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter that it's expensive.
Although, goatees?
Really, it's horrible. I can't find my journal.
And
I'm writing to Miguel in my journal. The boy in your class?
Me. Yeah, I have to find my journal.
Miguel.
Do we have... Yeah, she was like in love with Miguel.
Yeah.
Miguel.
Okay.
She looks in the classroom.
Sorry, it's not here.
It's not a good day for me. Okay, a little dramatic.
Miguel arrives. He has a pink journal in his hand.
Oh, no.
Oh, no, it's Miguel.
Hey, Zari, is this your journal?
Hey. No.
But your name is there.
Okay, yes, but I can't read it. Your writing is very bad.
Oh, good.
You want to go to a movie with me Friday? Ooh.
Wow. Wee.
Super. See you on Friday.
Lily, it's a super day.
Okay. So they're kind of dating.
Dating Miguel.
What do we know about him?
He is dating Zari.
Good for you.
Oscar is in the garden. He sees Eddy, his colleague. So Eddy is not just his friend, it's his colleague?
That would mean Eddy works at the high school, doesn't it? Because Oscar is also a teacher, high school art teacher.
Then he would probably be the gym teacher, right?
Colleague of Oscar, Rob's gym teacher, because of how obsessed he is with exercise.
I mean, that is a bit of a leap, but let's assume it doesn't have that complex of a plot structure, and it's not just like, oh, it's his very fanatical hobby. He probably also does it as his occupation. Or I could be surprised by Duolingo, who knows?
Eddy, why are you wearing a dress shirt today?
I have something,
a date,
and I'm late.
Eddy, always with the dates.
Do you have flowers or some chocolate for your date?
No,
and I'm late.
You can take some flowers from my garden.
I can't take these flowers.
Do you like this person?
Yeah, she's very funny.
So take these flowers.
Oscar, I don't want these flowers.
What? Eddy Eternu
sneezes.
That does sound like a bit of a stuffy nose. Eternu. When you say it, bit of a nose sound. Eddy, are you okay?
No, I'm allergic to flowers.
Oh no, you have red nose and eyes?
I don't feel well.
Good afternoon, Eddy. Thea arrives at Simon's house. Are you ready? It's the most important game of the year. And we have tickets. Do we have Simon? No, we don't have Simon. He looks vaguely familiar. Do you know what he looks like? He looks like Thomas's dad from the missing. Yeah. Tristan's dad. Oh, you know what's crazy? So Tristan is a character that was in a story that has vanished. He got retconned. So, I mean, he could still be Tristan's dad in this story. Line. The crazy thing is that, like, we haven't encountered Tristan again. So maybe now he's a single father, but he knows Bea. But, like, the whole deal with Tristan and his dad was that they were having a new baby and they had to get a bigger house. And that was the whole deal with it. So why are they in the same space now? We can't go back to the other stories yet because otherwise we'll lose all our progress. So we're just going to add Simon. Or should we edit Tristan's father? Because maybe he is Tristan's father, unless they rewrote the entire character. Possibly Simon, but possibly retconned by Duolingo. I can't go to the match. Why? Yeah. I have to study. So maybe he's not a dad anymore. I mean, he could be doing like his doctorate or graduate school or something, or night classes. I mean, I guess you can't assume he's not a student just because he might be older. I have a very important exam tomorrow. I need to have a good grade to enter medical school. Okay, interesting. So he is undergrad. So either he's no longer a father with two children, or he is a father with two children who's in undergrad school planning to go to medical school, which is a lot. Because, like, if you look at his son Tristan, and he's supposed to be a friend of Junior before that got retconned. Junior, I assume, is like 8 years old. So that means, like, Tristan is also probably around the same age, like 7 or 8. Most people finish undergraduate school by the time they're 22. So maybe he, like, took some years off, saved some money for university, and then went into undergrad. And now he's studying for medical school. I don't know if I'm reading too much into it because they may have just completely deleted his family. But if he still has his family, like, his vibe is interesting. I am sorry. Okay, Simon, do you have some coffee? Yeah, why? I can't be tired. Oh, she's gonna help him study. That's sweet. We're going to study all night. You're always there for me? Okay, what is their relationship? Seems like they're very good friends then. And today, I want to be there for you.
But it's the most important match of the year.
You are more important than a match. Very nice. And in the future, when you become a doctor, you buy some tickets for a big football match, okay? Of course, Bea.
Great, where's my coffee?
I will only help you to an extent. First, you must fuel me with caffeine. Then I will help. This is the other thing. So I posted the TikTok that was talking about the weird, mysterious missing mother of Junior. And someone in the comments was like, oh, I thought that Eddy and Junior were brothers and that the random third woman was the mom. And it, like, this was the thing too. For a second, I was like, oh my gosh, that's brilliant. Why didn't I think of that? And then I reread stories and I was like, no, he clearly says dad. So this is definitely his dad. But other people have also been like, oh, I think that the mom is actually his sister. And that just hasn't been determined yet. But the thing is, I don't know if I agree with that because the way I found this photo, because I could not find it again in the lessons, I actually think that they retconned this and removed it from the lessons. I found it by going through the definitions page, which is like a separate page in Duolingo where you can review all the vocabulary. And I went to the definition of family and they had this photo in the definitions section. And I was like, here it is. It took so long to find that photo. And it got to a point where I was like, did I imagine this? Like, am I making this up? And you know, the thing is, yes, she could be an older sister of Junior that is the daughter of Eddy. But there's another photo of her that I also included in that edit where it's like describing her as a wife or whatever. There's like a sentence that's like le mari or something. And she's like flashing a ring on her hand. And that just makes me think that she's the wife of Eddy. I think that she left him and they're divorced. And Eddy is a single father who for some reason has custody. I guess he does have a stable job if he works as a gym teacher. It's just never been clarified. So yet to discover that.